folks, ScrambledO checking in. Quick video for you guys today, out here in the woods, and as you can probably see behind me, the leaves have fallen off most of the trees. It's that time of year. It happens to be my favorite time of the year to be out in the woods. So today I'm picking up where I left off on Bushcraft A to Z, and today we're gonna be on letter H. And today I'm gonna be talking a little bit about hammocks, and I know hammocks aren't really bushcraft, but they're commonly used in the bushcraft community when people go out and do overnighters in the woods, so I thought it was a valid topic. So first things first, when you're hanging a hammock, you gotta find trees. First thing you're gonna wanna do is find some trees that are probably at least 10 feet apart, but no more than probably like 16 feet apart. So once you think you've found two trees that you can set up the hammock in, you're gonna wanna look above you. Make sure there's no dead trees, any dead branches hanging above you, because in the middle of the night, last thing you want is one of them big things coming down on top of you. Another thing you really gotta consider is you're putting a tarp above you for cover. You gotta kinda make sure that you're gonna have room around you for your tarp. So what I mean by that is there's a lot of places in the forest that are densely populated with trees. And if you've got trees every 3 feet, you may be able to find an area to set up the hammock, but then your tarp's not able to spread out. Sorry, you're not able to get the tarp hung spread out because there's trees everywhere. So you kinda need to find an open area where that the hammock's gonna be able to hang, and also your tarp can spread out. And depending on the configuration of the tarp, whether you're gonna use a square or a diamond or something a little bit different, will kinda dictate where you can hang your hammock. Here's my tarp that I use most of the time. It's a 10 by 10 Bushcraft Outfitters tarp. Basically with the hammock, it's a self-contained unit. So all you have to do is take it out of the pocket, and it's got carabiners that you use to wrap around your strap. You just take one end of your strap, pull it through this loop, and what you'll see is this strap has different loops. So that what you can do is try different tensions on the hammock, and you have different distances between the trees. These straps are good for that because it makes it nice and quick. So now you can kind of see how this works. The Atlas straps have several little loops that you put the carabiner through, depending on how tight you want it or how far apart the trees are. So for now, that should be good. The hammock ends, and the cordage that goes under the carabiner just comes right out of the end of the hammock. All right, first step hanging the tarp is the ridge line. So I take it around the tree, the tag end's on the right. I take the tag end, I wrap it around my two fingers, I twist into a circle and then pull it through. No idea what it's called, but it works pretty good for this first knot. All right, so I'm using the square setup, and to get my tarp attached to my ridge line, I use a prussic knot. Basically, I'm not sure if this is exactly how you do it. Basically, I take a piece of paracord that's already cut and tied into a small circle. I take it and I kind of just wrap it around a few different times. And this knot won't slide when you pull. Well, I guess it will. It's supposed to not slide. And if you do the knot right, it won't pull side to side. Here's the tarp. I don't know what these are even called. Grommets or something? I don't know. But you take this, where you took the prussic knot, and you take your loop, you stick it through there, and you put a little stick, it's a toggle, and then it pulls tight. See, what you got is a quick release on the tarp. So this knot is keeping the tarp from moving side to side down the ridge line, and this little twig I just picked up off the floor connects the two. At this point in time, you kind of got to decide, what do you want this tarp to provide you with? If it's gonna rain really hard, you need it to come down on top of you like a little teepee, an A-frame, or do you want to keep it opened up because you're going to have a fire? For this particular demonstration, I'm going to keep it open. So I'm going to stake down the backside and open up the front. I'll probably end up tying the corners of the tarp out to some trees somewhere around here. But the back, I'm going to stake down to the ground. right, got a little fire going. So today, Bushcraft A to Z, episode H, hammock hanging. I used to use a hammock every time I went out and did an overnighter, and I guess it just got old. If I had to pinpoint one reason why I don't like using a tarp in a hammock anymore, probably because it's more difficult than setting up a tent. For a tent, I can get out there, pull it out, I can be set up and ready to sleep in like 5 to 10 minutes. And it's the same thing every time. When you come out and you're hanging a tarp and a hammock, there's way more variables, there's way more things you have to think of and consider. And to be honest, it's just more difficult for me. I'm not as confident. Because look, you've got knots, you've got to remember different types of knots, you've got to have the right length of pieces of paracord, you've got to have the right situation with trees, you got to have the right trees around, they got to be the right distance apart, and also you actually have to have a working knowledge of how to hang the tarp, what configurations work for the right weather. So here's two examples of things that have gone wrong for me while I'm sleeping in a hammock. First thing was, I was at a bushcraft meet and there were no trees I could set up in that were the right distance apart. So I had to settle for something that the two trees were just much too far apart. And when I used paracord, the paracord stretched and snapped, fell out and hurt myself. Another time I had the knots incorrect. I didn't know exactly how to tie the knots on the trees and the hammock just slid down the trees onto the ground. And both of them were kind of embarrassing. I was in a group meet, you know, meeting a bunch of people for the first time, and I couldn't remember how to do any of this stuff. I sat at home and watched videos on YouTube and practiced knot making, and then I went out in the woods and it just escaped me. I couldn't remember how to do any of this stuff. So to me, hanging a hammock and a tarp is just much more complicated than it needs to be. I prefer sleeping in a tent because I'm not even using a bug net. Once you lay in underquilts and bug nets and all that stuff, I just think it's too complicated. I really think a hammock's an awesome thing to have, especially as a chair. I like to sit in it, relax, take a nap in it, but for overnighters, I prefer the tent. One benefit of being in a hammock with an open tarp like this is you're just way more connected to the outdoors. You feel way more part of the environment that you're in. It's hard for me to come up with anything better than sitting in a hammock, low to the ground, beautiful sunset, making a little twig fire. But it is super relaxing. Hammocks are great not only for overnighters, but also just to use as a little chair in the woods. All right, guys. Well, I think that about does it for me today. Just a quick video. Getting back to the series. Bushcraft A to Z, episode H, hammock hanging. Beautiful weather. Hopefully I can pop out some more videos for you guys soon. Till next time, ScrambledO signing off.